So glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the New York City Arena here in Midtown Manhattan for tonight's main event. 10 rounds of heavyweight action. Opening round scheduled for 10. All right, so you're wondering what you should be looking for in watching this fight. Number one on the list, how about his hook to the head?
You know, we're talking about it, Joe. The negative to that is his opponent should be aware of it, too. And they should have a counter for it.
Nice block by King. Good combination punching by Blood. Hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination.
Nice.
He scored well after being hit himself. Halfway through round number one. Blood's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. Combination punching here is showing you what good boxing is all about. Three punches thrown, three punches landed. Digs in with a good solid uppercut after taking a shot.
Mike can't focus.
Oh, and he's got something for him himself, and it's a left hand. Final 10 seconds of round number one. That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Blood. Pistol statistics really shine in that last round. You can see that he was able to land more punches than his opponent. Now, it's not black and white. You land more punches, you win the round. But in this case, I do think he's up on the scorecards based on that round.
Yeah, I believe he is too. You know, you're looking at it, and you just feel that he's got control of the pace, the tempo. I mean, he's know, taking. He's winning the fight, but there's a risk there because he's starting to throw a lot of punches, sometimes a little carelessly. That's going to leave him a little bit open to a counter.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Didn't get it done going to the body there. Pistol's the kind of boxer that wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches.
Back to the body.
How about a return to sender with the left hand? Keeping his hands up, getting rid of his opponent's offense. Too good jab by Blood. Blood's able to land a nice, clean left hand. Well, you can just tell that he's unable to keep up this kind of a pace early on. You can see that these punches aren't what they were.
So that's part of the equation. You go out there and you can chuck leather at your opponent, but your opponent, he can handle it. If he wants to, he can deflect it, and then he starts coming back with his own. And then what happens? You get tired, you start giving up.
Uppercut absolutely rocked him. Oh! Oh, big crush! Uppercut floors him.
One, two.
He went down from a big shot. Now he's got to have some big guts to move along.
You're gonna find out exactly what he's made of.
Landing two jabs by King. misses his opponent's headshot.
Oh,
nice strike after catching one by Blood. Now he's putting his punches together, the combination upstairs.
Relax, relax.
King's feeling great right now, and why not? He just scored the knockdown, and now he's got that eye. He's got that target, that vision. He knows what he can get after.
And there's no reason why he wouldn't have that. Right now, the only thing that he has to be careful that he doesn't have is overconfidence. He doesn't get reckless.
Blood's recovered nicely here. The start of this round, and he is proving to me at least that what happened in that last round is having no effect on this round. Pistol showcasing one of the best weapons you can have, especially early on in a fight, to set the tone, and that is the jab.
Yeah, and he's shown that it does more than just set up other punches and, you know, just, you know, snap your head back. It disrupts everything. You know, it just blows the other guy's rhythm off, and that's what he's doing a good job of.
Doubling up that jab, it serves him well to the body. Great job. He gave one right back in return. Nice work by Pistol. Great hook to the head that time.
Smash to the body.
Halfway through this round.
There you go.
Teddy, I've heard you say it a million times early on in the fight. If there's any one piece of good advice you can give, you start depositing it into that bank. Go to the body.
Yeah, because the interest comes later, and you're going to see the payoff in the late rounds.
Another jab comes in by King. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Blood. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. King's blocking ability is doing well for him there. Seconds remaining in this round. And that's the end of round three. Pistol's enjoying a big lead here, Teddy. And we talk about this often as we begin round number four, up 3-0 on your scorecard. When you have scored a knockdown that early in a fight, a real hole for your opponent to try to overcome.
Yeah, because now he has to start taking chances that maybe weren't in the game plan. And as he takes chances, gets a little reckless, and as you're seeing, gets caught more.
Do you see any way in which he can take his opponent's aggression and turn it against him?
Yeah, the perfect way. I mean, boxing 101, counterpunching. You got a guy coming at you, no better way than to change his mind. Make him miss, make him pay.
They trade shots. He comes back with a right hand.
Keep moving.
Now that is fighting right there, and smart fighting, landing all four punches. Blood's been stunned.
Freeze. Ace yourself.
Look at that. And once again, he goes down. The question is, can he rise up again?
King's in prime form. Power surge here. Knockout winner.